because I just had my first ever veteran celebrity edition episode with the man, the myth, the legend, all around badass, retired Marine and champion of the hit TV series, Tough as Nails. That's right. I'm talking about Kelly Murphy, AKA Murph. And on this episode, we're gonna get to hear about his journey as a Marine, the struggle of facing retirement, and all of the background details on his journey through winning Tough as Nails season one.
Actually, October 2019, Jonathan sent me another message and said, "Hey, Murph, CBS is putting together this show. It's called Tough as Nails. I think you'd be amazing. Here's a link. You have to fill it out so they can contact you." So I filled the link out. The next day, CBS, Gabriel from CBS Casting sends me a message. "Hey, can you Zoom tomorrow?" So I did a Zoom call, and about 2 weeks later, he said, "Hey, CBS loved your Zoom. Can you do another Zoom?" So I said, "Cool." So I did another Zoom call. And this time it was actually with Phil, his wife, and some of the other producers. The call lasted like not even 90 seconds.
You were a shoe-in, Murph. Let's be real.
Well, I walked away going, "Man, that was fast." I mean, I think it's a great show. And the best part about the show, too, is that there's no script. Like, I had to read no lines. Phil just said, "Be yourself and do this stuff the best you can." So there was no like, "Hey, Murph, you said that wrong. Could you retake?" And there was nothing like that. So that's the best part of the show. It's 100% real. There's nothing fake about it. Of course, you're going to never forget your boot camp graduation, because you're standing there and your drill instructor says, "Platoon 1,115 dismissed." You take the one step back, scream out, "Aye, sir." And when you do that about face, you're now officially United States Marine. So I mean, the Marines needed air support. One of our primary aircraft, it had some avionics issues. So I went out to the aircraft, troubleshot the aircraft, got it fixed, and they were able to launch instead of having to tow the backup out to launch the backup. So we were able to launch the aircraft, is able to provide that close air support. And then we didn't lose any Marines on the beach. So it was just a proud moment for me because, you know, you train all the time, you work on the aircraft, but you never are in a situation all the time where you're working on the aircraft where somebody's life depends upon whether or not you could fix it or not.
What led to your retirement? Because that, you seem like you could have just gone on and did anything and it would have worked out for you.
And the transition, I mean, it was hard. It was, I thought I was prepared. You know, I prepared myself for interview, resume, transitioning. I got the job. You know, I got everything I was looking for, but the mental part of not being a Marine anymore was tough. Like, so I was invited to be a part of the VFW. I turned them down. American Legion turned them down. I didn't want to be a part of any veteran organization whatsoever. And the reason why was I was really afraid that being around these veterans would make me miss the Marine Corps more than I already did. I would say 2.5-3 years ago, I just hit rock bottom and I broke down and crying in my truck. And so I went and actually talked to a counselor for once a week for almost like 2 to 3 months. I just felt overwhelmed with everything going on in my life. You know, still adjusting to the transition. So I ended up, you know, going to a counselor and, you know, it was just having somebody to talk to. And there's nothing wrong with asking for that help or seeking that help out either. Some of my best friends that are like, no kidding, combat war heroes have went and talked to people. So, I mean, that's one of the reasons I went, because I'm like, man, if he can do it, then I can do it. So, you know, there's nothing wrong with going to talk to somebody if you're struggling. It's definitely, it's worth it. Your life is worth it, you know?
Thank you for sharing that, man. I've hit a rock bottom myself and yeah, we don't have to do it alone. So we shouldn't, you know what I mean?